And we are in the kitchen that's now outdoors with Linkie Marais cooking and grilling up some pizza.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's hot out here, but really we're going to heat it up some more.
I know. I can't even look over there because the sun is in my eyes.
I know. It's like, woo.
Grilled sun-dried tomato and bacon pizza with blue cheese.
So with blue cheese, yes.
Let's get through the ingredients before everything melts.
Absolutely, okay. Yes. You know, and I left the dough on ice. That way we make sure our dough doesn't go to pieces. But the dough is basically this yeast recipe with like flour and yeast and some sugar and salt. Oh. Very easy.
Okay.
You can even, you know, turn it into bread or calzones.
Make it from scratch?
Yes, I make it from scratch.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And then we've got some mozzarella. We've got some bacon. And then this is a sauce I made early this morning, which is basically a Parmesan type of a white sauce, almost like a, not really an Alfredo,
that's
but it's
basically what the mozzarella is going to look like.
Yes, yes, this is what the mozzarella is going to look like in a little bit. And then we've got some blue cheese and then some sun-dried tomatoes. And this is going to add a really nice sweetness to the pizza, to the pizza that you won't be able to, you know, won't be able to miss. And then we're going to top it off with some basil.
Okay.
And we're going to bake them into these
little mini pans.
Aren't they
like
adorable?
It's like a pie.
It's like a pie. It's like a little mini pizza pie. And then we're going to bake this on the mini big green egg. So what you do is you...
I've never seen that.
Isn't it cute?
Yeah,
I mean, it's
very
just precious. So we're going to use this plate setter that we're going to set right there.
Okay.
And then basically what this allows to do is this is almost like a barrier between the coals and the pizza. So then when you close it up, it turns it into an oven.
Okay.
So it gets that nice and smoky flavor from the, you know, from the coals and everything, and you have a pizza, and it's easy, it's fast, it's perfect.
Awesome, awesome. I can't wait to taste it. How long does it take to cook?
This is like literally once I crank this sucker up to like 400, 500, it takes 15 to 20 minutes, and it's done.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we'll check in back with you, you know, and I'll go back inside with a little cooler.
Where you're not melting your face off.
All right. Thank you, Linkie.
Knew it was going to be hot outside today until I stepped outside here and realized how hot it actually was. And just to make it even warmer, we have a grill and we're setting the grill. We got fire on the grill because we are grilling pizzas this morning.
We're grilling pizzas, yes. And this grill is already at 450.
Yeah.
Like it's not hot
like it's
enough.
Not hot enough out here.
So this is very easy. What we're going to do is we're going to use these little cutesy little mini pizza pans.
Okay.
And we're going to, here, you're going to make yours, I'm going to make mine.
All right.
What you're going to do is you're going to sprinkle a little bit of cornmeal.
Okay.
There we go.
And what does that help so it doesn't stick, or
so
it just gives?
It doesn't stick, and it gives a little bit of a crunch.
On the bottom of the crust, right?
Yeah, so it's perfect.
Okay.
And before we go on, let me quickly put this plate setter back in. And this plate setter basically...
Oh, that is nice.
Isn't that cool?
So then you can just take this and just pop it on top
of it. And just pop it on top. And when it's great, it's like a barrier between the coals and, you know, so it you know.
Oh, like a heat stone.
Yes, yeah, so it's
heat
almost like a you know, convection oven.
Right, okay.
So then I pre-made this dough last night and I kept it in here so I can keep it in the cooler.
Right.
And what you're going to do is you just literally actually grab a little bit of olive oil on your hand.
All right.
Like
put that on. Okay.
Yeah, just a little bit like that. And, you know, you can use flour, too, but since it's so hot out here, we'll just use a little bit of olive oil. And you're going to pinch off about like that. Here, let me dump it in here so it's easier for you.
Okay.
There we go.
All right, got it.
Look, everything's melting.
I'm melting!
And we'll just set this aside. Yeah, so you just grab a little bit, pinch it off.
Okay.
And then we're just going to
kind of just work it.
Yeah. We're not going to toss it now because I'm scared it's going to end up on your face. There you go.
Okay.
Yeah, like that.
Like this here?
Yeah, and then you're basically going to get it into your pan.
Mm-hmm.
And then just, I'm going to add a little bit of more of olive oil. You can use flour actually too. Let me move that out of the way. And then you're just going to flatten it into your little pan.
Okay, move it around in here, right?
Yeah, move it around and basically spread it to the ends.
All right.
Grab some flour too if you need some. And what you want to do is you want it all the way to the edges.
Okay.
And
actually, that's not too bad.
Yeah, right? It's easy. You don't have to.
Easy enough to do.
Yeah.
And I think these pans work great too. Now, some people will take it just and put it on a hot grill as it is, even without the pans, but this makes it much easier.
Yeah, this is much easier and it's much more clean. And you can actually, if you have a party or something going on, you can pre-make all of these.
Okay.
Like just keep them on the pan, wrap them up. And then what we're going to do is then we're going to start topping it.
And put some of the toppings on
there
too.
Okay. Yes.
All right. So we're going to do that in just a little bit. And we're going to make these pizzas and put them back on the green egg on the grill.
Yep.
Out here, I'm ready to melt now. Back to you. We are back outside again in the backyard barbecue. Linkie Marais is here. We're cooking, we're grilling pizzas today. Deanna Cruz is hanging out with us today, co-hosting, while Michaela is out and Meg's out on vacation. All right, what do we got going on now?
We have got pizzas going on, like you just said.
Yep.
And what I went ahead and did is I went ahead and topped it very lightly with the sauce that I made. It's almost like a Parmesan bechamel, if you will.
Ooh, that looks
and
good.
Then here, you guys can get your hands dirty too.
Okay.
So then we're going to top it with a little bit of mozzarella.
Right.
Okay. There you go.
Put a little mozzarella on here.
Yeah. All right. mozzarella.
Yep.
Mozzarella.
Mozzarella. Like yes, mozzarella. Oh,
yeah. And then we're going to top it with some bacon. Here.
You want bacon on it?
You can go. Do the bacon. I'll
you,
do. Can
you
I
don't want bacon?
Do, yes, you can do that.
She's like, I'm not a huge fan of bacon.
Are you really?
Yeah. Believe
what?
It or not.
Bacon makes everything better.
That's what everyone says.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. The heat is getting to me.
I think it is.
All right, top this one too with bacon. There you go. I'll work around.
All right, you know what? We're going to switch it. She doesn't want bacon.
You and I will
have
bacon.
No, she doesn't want bacon. She's going to have sun-dried tomatoes.
And then sun-dried tomatoes. We'll put some. Do you eat? Do you eat onions?
Yes, I do. Yeah,
yeah. Some onions. There we go.
It's my special pizza.
And then something.
No bacon for me.
And then something that just adds like a little zing to it is some blue cheese.
Ooh,
I like blue cheese.
You like blue cheese?
Yes. It has already kind of melted a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're just going to kind of shave off a little piece here and there.
Okay.
We'll spread this out some.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
It'll add just a little extra flavor to it.
Just
a little extra, zing to it.
It's perfect. This one doesn't here.
Okay.
All right.
So we'll do this one.
This one doesn't have sun-dried tomatoes.
Oh, I thought he didn't want sun-dried tomatoes.
No, I want sun-dried tomatoes.
He wants it all.
Okay, thanks for spreading the blue cheese.
There you go. Yeah, some blue cheese.
Pizza, well.
Some blue cheese. Very
and
nice of you.
Thank
this
you.
This one, I've already, I've gotten this grill right up to about 450, 500.
Okay.
So then we're going to pop one of these on there. We're going to take this one off.
Okay.
And this grill is nice and hot. And like I said, that plate setter allows the barrier between that. Actually, you know, this should be good. Let me just put
this
it right here.
Put this down.
And look at that. Does that not look delicious?
It does
look
good.
Yes.
There we go. And then what we do is we just pop it out. Let me get this out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Pop it out. This is hot, but if you can't handle the heat, get out of the kitchen, right? There
that's
go.
Good. Mm. These are great if you're having, as you were saying, if you're having company come over and you can just pop these things in. It's also fun for even like kids to do. If you got the kids around to do, easy enough to make.
And look, this literally cooks in about 15, 20 minutes.
Because because the green egg gets so hot, too,
it gets
right?
so hot, so it almost turns into a convection oven, pizza kind of thing. So it's perfect. So we'll get that up, get that. And then we're going to top this with a little bit of balsamic. Just to add some sweetness to it.
Okay.
I thought that was suntan lotion or something. I mean, we're outside.
I thought it was chocolate syrup for something.
We need it. I know, right? And look at that. Is that not
perfect? That looks good.
Yeah, that looks
awesome. And beautiful, right?
Mm-hmm.
There we go.
Okay. All right, let's have a taste of this.
Okay, you didn't take my piece.
It should be nice and hot.
I want this one.
It's hot. It's good.
It has bacon on it.
That's okay. I'll try to eat around.
You will try to eat around the bacon. Mm-hmm. Here, let's see.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
No.
Oh, that's good.
That's delicious.
And I like the balsamic vinegar on it too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's really good.
A little bit of sweetness along with the tomatoes.
Wow,
so it's perfect.
Very, very good.
Great thing about this, it's so easy, and there's the rest of the weekend left if you don't die out there with the heat stroke.
No, not a chance. Can we cook this on the pavement? I'm wondering because it's so hot.
I bet we can.
It is so hot.
I bet we can. I bet we can.
All right. Yeah. You came in here today with us, but what other things do you have? You got anything cool going on?
Well, I have this great class coming up next week. It's at the Rhode Island Kitchen and Bath. Mm-hmm. It's called Salads and Daiquiris. So it's perfect. It's like nice and summery, and I'm going to do some great daiquiris, some strawberry daiquiris, some mojitos.
Nice.
Yeah, and then some great salads to go with that. You know, so if you're trying to cut, you know, some calories, then come
this
have salad and then have the liquor afterwards.
Yeah. And if anybody wants to get to go do this, do we need tickets ahead of time or how do we do this?
Yes, you can register on my website. It's called livinglinkie.com.
Okay.
And you can just go ahead and register on there and you'll be ready to go.
Yeah. All right, perfect.
So it's very cool.
We have pizzas. And you know what? One more thing, just quickly, because I know we've talked about it before, but give us a little background on the Big Green Egg.
Mm. The Big Green Egg is amazing. You can smoke on it. You can grill on it. Mm. You can bake on it like we're baking the pizza right now.
Right.
And what it is it's a ceramic grill that you control with airflow up here and up here.
Mm-hmm.
So basically it turns into a convection oven when you're baking the pizza. I mean, look,
it's
already browning on top. So it's perfect. Huh. It's great. It's
How much does one of those things cost?
This was a gift.
Okay. I'm just wondering, you know.
But you can find that on their website.
Right. All right, we're going to Google.
Absolutely.
Okay, thanks for coming in today.
Thank you for
And if you want this recipe and how easy it was to make this, you can head to our website, WPRI.com/Rhode Show.